I am Maxime Petit from École Centrale de Lyon, and I will present our work at this ICDL Epirope conference entitled Bayesian Optimization for Developmental Robotics with Meta-Learning by Parameters Bound Reduction. We want to tackle the issue of optimization for robotic software, treated as black box algorithm, which can be seen as hyperparameter optimization. For instance, in industrial settings, parameters for a grasping robot have to be optimized in order to manipulate the specific object, and the introduction of new objects lead to new costly optimization. We aim at minimizing the number of parameters trial of the algorithm, producing in return a performance score that we want to be maximized. One of the methods of choice for hyperparameter tuning is the Bayesian optimization. It is especially suited when the cost function is expensive and noisy, which is usually the case in robotics applications, under the condition that the number of parameters is limited. We propose to enhance the performance of the Bayesian optimization by adding a long-term autographical memory to the robot, allowing it to store data during its lifetime. It is composed of an episodic memory gathering data from experiments, a procedural memory to save optimized skill set, and a semantic memory with knowledge about the shape of known objects. Instead of launching the Bayesian optimization from scratch, like an amnesic robot, this memory will allow the system to avoid unpromising areas in the search space by reducing the parameters boundaries for a new task using its experience on a similar task previously learned. As experiment, the application will use the grasping of objects in an homogeneous heap from an industrial robotic arm, both in simulation and in reality. The black box method to be optimized is Kamido, a proprietary software providing a grasping target for the robot based on a top view RGBD image of the scene. We will optimize 9 continuous parameters of Kamido when wide trial or iteration consists of 15 grasping attempts. Overall, we have a very small budget for optimization run, especially for noisy observation, with 10 initial iterations to estimate the landscape, then 20 led by Bayesian optimization. Bayesian optimization is an efficient trial and error method because of its smart selection of the experiment to run based on the result of the previous ones. You want to optimize the true unknown function, the dashed line, by creating a model of it called the surrogate function with its uncertainty as seen by the purple shade that you can analyze. Initially, you want to cover as much parameter space as possible in order to have a rough estimation of the landscape. Then, each new trial, called iteration, will test a set of parameters that will produce a score, and the model of the true function will be updated accordingly, reducing its uncertainty. The selection of the next point is done through a specific acquisition criteria on the surrogate function, with a trade-off between exploration and exploitation. Human long-term memory is split in 3 memories: the semantic, storing general knowledge and facts about the world; the episodic, where you can find your personal experiences, events that you can recall and play specifically; and then the procedural, responsible of storing skills. The drawing on the right provides an example. Remembering an encounter with a mouse will be a specific event taken from the episodic memory, whereas knowing what a mouse is and looks like will come from the semantic memory. An example of the procedural memory will be how to chase the mouse. When applied to our robot, these memories are implemented as a PostgreSQL database. We store in the episodic the parameters value and score for every iteration. The semantic will contain the CAD model of the object known by the robot, that is, the one that have been learned. It will be used to check the similarity between objects, with the hypothesis that objects that are similar between each other will be grasped properly with similar parameters value. Eventually, the procedural will regroup all the best set of optimized parameters per run. With the data stored in the episodic memory, the robot can now perform a posteriori analysis of its experiences. Indeed, it can extract the normalized value of all parameters tested during the best iterations for specific object runs. When considering almost all iterations, like the best 95% on top left, we can check that the Bayesian optimization is covering quite well the full search space. However, when you focus on the more successful iterations, like the best 25% on the bottom right, you can see that some parameters value areas are never exploited, meaning that they are unpromising regions. We want to estimate them in order to reduce the initial parameters bound accordingly, thus reducing the search space and increasing the Bayesian optimization efficiency for future similar tasks. When considering only the best iteration, neutral boundaries of the Bayesian optimization for normalized parameter values lead to uniform 0-1 distribution. If not, that means that some areas are more explored, and some unpromising regions are usually discarded. For all the parameters distribution of the best iteration for a specific object, we use an algorithm to check the uniformity with the Dodridge van der Meulen test, coupled with the Wilcoxon test for the median at 0.5, in order to know if we should reduce the upper boundary, like parameter 8 and 9 in this example, increase the lower one, parameter 3, 5 and 6, or both, parameter 4. The robot will then be able to use its past experience in order to perform more efficient Bayesian optimization by reducing the initial cell space when considering a new object to grasp, based on the analysis of the distribution of the parameter's value for the previous optimization of a similar object. In this example, the robot has to optimize the grasping of a new object called M784. Initially, it will query its semantic memory in order to extract the most similar known object previously optimized, that is, M782. The robot will then use the analysis of the parameter distribution of M782, stored in the episodic memory, to create a new reduced search space with more constrained boundaries, saved into the procedural memory. Finally, this smaller search space will be applied to the new Bayesian optimization of the M784 object grasping task. You can see here the whole cognitive architecture and data flow between components, in particular the exchange between the long-term memory, composed by the episodic, procedural and semantic memory, and the reasoning modules, namely the Bayesian optimization, the parameters bound reduction, and the visual similarity. Experiments were done first in simulation, with the optimization of 7 objects on top and the corresponding data from the most similar object known, previously optimized, at the bottom. You can see in the table the default boundaries for each parameter on the first line, and the corresponding reduced boundaries for the similar object previously optimized with the modification in red. You can see here a comparison of the overall performance during the optimization without meta-learning to the left, corresponding to an amnesic robot, and with it to the right, corresponding to a robot with the cognitive architecture. The mean performance score, the percentage of successful grasp, is plotted for each iteration number. The first 10 iterations, to the left of the dashed line, are part of the initial design of the search space, when points are selected in order to maximize the coverage. There is a clear warm start phenomenon during the initial phase when using the meta-learning method, going from around 55% to 70%. Showing that the robot is avoiding the most unpromising area, leading to a better optimization trajectory. Indeed, when we compare the overall final performance of the optimization for all the objects, we go from 78.9% to 84.3% with the meta-learning strategy, a statistically significant improvement. This is validated further when considering the comparison of the final performance object per object. We consistently achieve a better optimization when using meta-learning. We also validated the framework with a real robot experiment using a phonic arm. For grasping target, we also used a soft body object, a property that was not available in simulation, with a rubber tube with elbow shape. With this experiment in reality, we also observed an increase in performance when using the meta-learning strategy. So we designed a developmental cognitive architecture allowing a robot to fine-tune efficiently hyperparameters of its method by using a trial and error approach, even for noisy and expensive evaluation. This technique is based on a Bayesian optimization, where the robot can use its past experience from similar, previously learned tasks when confronting to the learning of a new one. Thus, one of the key components is the autobiographical memory of the robot, allowing a posteriori analysis of the parameter distribution for the best iteration, leading to a new reduced search space. We have validated the approach with simulated experiments on object grasping from Ogenesis, with good results from 30 learning iterations to optimize 9 parameters of a grasping software. We showed a significant increase of performance when using the meta-learning strategy, as opposed to without. The architecture has also been tested and implemented within a real industrial setting, showing again an increase of performance when reducing the search space for similar tasks. For future work, one of our leads is to use this meta-learning approach using a simulated object for initial optimization and apply it when confronted to the same object, but in reality. We also plan to merge this meta-learning strategy with a transfer learning method that we developed before. It consists on forcing the robot to test initially the optimized set of parameters found for a similar object. We expect additional gain in performance by merging both of these methods. Eventually, we are also interested to link this work with the symbol emergence domain, with the hypothesis some specific range of parameters are linked to physical properties of the object. For instance, grasping a small object always leads to an optimization where a parameter pi is between 0.7 and 1. It can then be used in two ways. If optimization of the robot for a new object leads to such case, the robot can discover that this object can actually be defined as small. On the opposite, if the robot has to optimize an object described as small by the human, the robot can automatically reduce its cell space based on that description.